Geely is officially, statistically officially, the fastest growing car company in the world this year by a massive margin. It's not even close. Second place is so far behind, we don't even know who they are. I mean, seriously. The Geely Group sales have grown by just over 50% worldwide this year, and their exports have increased by 67%, largely on the back of distributing, selling some of the most advanced EVs in China and outside of China. So what is driving Geely's success? I mean, what are the reasons why Geely are having this incredible surge? Well, I'm pretty sure I've got a good idea. Here's what I think. In spite of the woes of Polestar, who lost $1.2 billion last year, the Geely Group, well, they're doing incredible this year. Sales of their vehicles has blown up by 40% for the first 5 months. And Geely have just reported that for the most part, they're actually making a profit on their electric cars, which is something that only BYD and Tesla can currently claim. Hello, my friends. Welcome to the channel. I'm Sam Evans. You're watching The Electric Viking. It's great to see you. Thank you for tuning in. Now, it is true, guys. I know you've seen a lot of reports about Polestar, its problems. It's facing a lot of problems, a lot of challenges. But even though Polestar is one of Geely's brands, Geely have many different electric car brands, and its other EV brands like Lynk & Co, Zeekr, and of course, Geely itself are actually doing incredibly well. Geely Automobile Holdings, the Hong Kong listed unit of billionaire Li Shufu's auto empire, said first quarter profit has surged, helped by a huge jump in car sales worldwide. Net income more than doubled to 215 million in the 3 months ending March 31 from a year earlier. Revenue increased by 56% to 52.3 billion yen, or not that far off $10 billion. It's the first time Geely has reported quarterly earnings, putting it in line with sister company Zeekr Intelligent Technology Holdings, which listed in the US last month. Now, unlike Polestar, Zeekr has seen a rapid rise. And of course, that brand and Zeekr themselves are one of the key reasons why Geely are doing so well this year. Their sales have grown significantly versus last year. Geely sold nearly 500,000 cars in the first 3 months of the year. That's 476,000, up 50% from a year earlier, making it now the 10th biggest car company in the world. Rival BYD, which only sells EVs and plug-in hybrids, posted sales of 624,400 vehicles in the same period at a slower growth rate, significantly slower growth of 14%. So Geely has set a target to sell 1.9 million vehicles this year. And realistically, it's probably more likely to sell a lot more than that because the company sells more cars in China than anywhere else, of course. And China is really a country that buys vehicles, well, usually in the third and fourth quarter of the year. So generally, about twice as many cars will be sold in the final 6 months of the year versus the first 6 months of the year. Really, there's a good chance that Geely will actually sell more like 2.5 million cars, meaning it will almost certainly jump a few positions in the global rankings in terms of sales. But I think what's more to me, guys, what's more interesting here is the 50% growth rate. I mean, 50% growth. No one else is doing that. I don't know of any other car company, big car company, top 12 car company in the world, growing at anywhere near that kind of speed. And if you look at these numbers here, I mean, it's strange we're not talking about Geely because, I mean, the fact that they're selling 476,000 cars, BYD 625,000, Geely are actually not that far off BYD's numbers. Thanks to significant sales growth and continuous optimization of the product structure, the group's revenue increased rapidly compared to the same period last year, said Geely. Now, the biggest reason, in my opinion, for their growth is, Volvo and Zeekr selling more EVs. And it's not just for their current growth, which, that's not driving all their current sales. Obviously, the Geely brand as well is selling more EVs. The biggest reason that I see is that they make really good EVs. And yeah, they're increasing their sales of those and they're focusing on those. Now, unfortunately, the Geely Group still are investing huge sums of money into internal combustion. And that to me is just going to be a big write-off they're going to have to make at some point in the future. Now, a lot of people think that's a good thing. They think internal combustion, no, EVs were all overhyped. Actually, internal combustion is coming back. Now, I don't think that's happening. And I think that's insane that people believe that. I honestly think that's sort of like saying that, you know, religion's coming back in a big way. It's like, it's, you know, most people now don't practice religion. But a lot of people who are still in it, you know, a lot of people who are still doing it, they're saying, no, that's got to come back. And, you know, Jesus will come again and the second coming will happen and everyone will start going back into religion. I don't think that's very likely, but I could be wrong. Let me know what you think of my analogy. Maybe it was a bad one. I don't know. Geely shares closed 1.2% lower in Hong Kong, but the stock is up 2.4% this year. And honestly, I see Geely stock being probably a pretty good buy because, I mean, their technology. Here's one of the things we're not pointing out. We should be. Geely's new Aegis battery or Golden battery, their lithium iron phosphate battery, it's probably slightly better technology than BYD's new version 2 blade battery, which is not out on the market yet. Geely already have their Aegis battery on the market. It's in some cars you can buy now. Lithium iron phosphate battery technology that they have is absolutely next level. And they seem to be able to integrate this technology into their cars. Don't seem to be. They are integrating it faster than anyone else. There's no other car manufacturer in the world using this Keitel's Shenzhen battery, plus Keitel's Jilin battery, plus the most advanced LFP battery in the world in their cars. And they have been doing that now for nearly about six to 12 months. No one else is doing that. You know, combining the best battery technology from other manufacturers and their own and selling those in cars that are going global. And that's why I think we should be taking them pretty seriously and starting to think to ourselves, well, actually, these guys are doing some impressive things. Because if you consider that, plus the fact that most of their cars are made using structural battery packs, using gigacasting machines, 8,000 ton gigacasting machines. No one's even talking about this. Geely, to be honest, guys, Geely's promotion and marketing is shocking. They are terrible. This is their, Geely make great cars. Their marketing is horrendous. People criticize Tesla, but I'm telling you now, guys, the marketing for the Geely brands in general, and I know some of these people, so I'm sorry, guys, but the truth is your marketing sucks. I mean, you have the best products, you got the best battery technology, and no one knows about it. I mean, yeah, people in China, some of them are doing their research, they're figuring this out for themselves, but realistically, the West doesn't know about this stuff. They don't know about, how many people, if you ask them in the West, you said, you know, Zeekr have the 001 FR, which is one of the fastest cars in the world, and it's basically a family car with massive spoilers in the back, it's got carbon ceramic brakes, it's cheaper than a Tesla Model S Plaid. How many people would know about that vehicle, just how insanely good that is? Not how anyone does. So I really think the biggest thing here that they can do to improve their company is to improve their marketing. Get more of this product out there. Let us know about all the things you guys are doing, because I mean, you're putting the latest battery technology in your cars. I've been saying this now for a long time. It's going into your cars faster than anyone else. I mean, why doesn't everyone know about this? People know about this from this channel that I talk about, but not everyone watches my channel. Obviously there's billions of people who don't. So yeah, that's one key issue that I think they can improve on. That's an easy issue. That's an easy thing to do. It's difficult to make a great product. The engineering involved is insane. But to market that product, it's a lot more simple. Geely is seeing results of its transition to EVs with sales of EVs more than doubling this year. More than doubling. However, the owner said that earlier this month, competition in China is the most intense in the world. And that's why it's insane, the fact that Geely's vehicles have grown sales in China this year by, I believe, about 40 or 50%. Between 40 and 50%. And that's even in this insane situation where they're having to compete in this bloodbath in China. That tells you all you need to know. If they're succeeding in that situation, they can pretty much succeed anywhere. There is some challenges, of course. You know, the fact that now the taxes on EVs in Europe and the United States are massive, but Geely can pivot. They can sell more EVs in places outside of there. Plus, they're now making the Volvo EX30 in Belgium, and they're going to export those to the US. They're also going to be making EVs in America as well. So they're covering those bases off probably better than any other Chinese manufacturer. I mean, as far as we know, BYD doesn't have any current factories to build cars in the US. They do have a factory they're building in Hungary, but I believe that, you know, the global thing, probably Geely in a bit of an advanced position. You know, they have many Volvo dealerships already around the world, existing dealerships. So they're in a bit of a better position to kind of capitalize on global success, I think anyway. Exports are continuing to grow. Geely shipped 87,000 cars overseas in the first 3 months, which is a 66% increase. The momentum may be impacted by the EU proposed tariffs on EVs, Geely's EVs, which is 20% plus the existing 10% in place. But anyway, the point is that realistically, these sales figures are pretty staggering. I mean, growth in exports of 66%. Sales have grown just over 50% this year so far. Yeah, no one's really reporting on this, guys. I'm not sure why, but let me know what you think in the comments. Thanks for watching.